Greetings, everyone. Today's topic is wisdom peace. This will be the finale for Divine Topics. True wisdom can be the ability to discern inner voices, common sense, or generally accepted beliefs. The ability to discern inner voices give us true wisdom, and we can make best choices in decision making with less mistakes. A wise person observes internally as well as externally before reacting and responding in haste to avoid undesirable consequences. Wisdom is not determined by how many degrees you may have acquired, but by practical application that you obtain and apply to your knowledge base. For the most part, common sense will assist in the process because the ability to identify that which is wrong or that which is unobtainable. Let's go to Scripture Foundation from our wisdom books or authors that wrote these books out of inspiration, revelation, or experience. Job appeared to be a patient, also known as a saint, who righteously endured suffering but was despaired in receiving fair treatment by God. God wanted Job to know that in his suffering, he had a hidden plan. So when we remain faithful and acknowledge him, we do, we get the prize. Internally, it's an internal peace. It was never a battle if Job would have cursed God. It was Satan's challenge. Remember, he had the same power, but God has all power. So what saved Job is he had God in him manifested. He had wisdom. Let's go to the book of Psalms, wisdom. As we read Psalms, we must recognize the carefully fine-tune and revise for individualism and growth. So our focus should be to use our wisdom as productiveness for God. God is intimately involved with the way of the righteous, but has no connection to the way of the ungodly. So if we're living an ungodly life, rest assured God is not a part of it. He's there to protect you, but we shouldn't try to take advantage of his gratefulness. In Ecclesiastes, Solomon concludes that eternity is in our heart, and it is to have reverence, also known as acknowledge, worship, and serve, and turn away from evil and be in awe with the living God. Someone said, I'm in awe. I am in awe with God. Song of Solomon suggests that we remain prayerful, fasting as keeping our hearts clean, and giving thanks. We also have 9 more books that I won't have time to cover, but as we study these, I will identify Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Haggai, Malachi, Hosea, Zephaniah, and Proverbs. As Proverbs, I don't want to dig in and fine tune through all the wisdom books, but just pieces that will lead you to continue to review. The book of Proverbs, the beginning of knowledge. Some to the beginning was in Genesis, but Proverbs identifies action to the wisdom, to know, to perceive, and lastly, to receive. This is how wisdom is acquired. First, we receive it, and then we apply it. It is no point in receiving it if we are not going to apply it. Then it's useless. So a change occurred from this application, and that's what we're looking for, commitment. Person that I've obtained the most wisdom learned through an experience or example. But remember, there is always another height to reach and learn. So in close, never rely on others' words or hearsay. Acquire and apply is the key to wisdom and understanding. And thank you for listening. God bless everyone. And this is the end of the Divine Topics. This is the finale. I hope everyone got a chance to listen to this series, and stay tuned.